Coming up next on ATETV. Water treatment technology.
Water is depleting all over the world, and I mean, we just have more and more need for fresh drinking water.
Information technology security.
The information degree security program is designed to teach students like me to go into various businesses to help them secure their networks against different types of attacks.
And fuel cell technology.
I want to be in on the ground floor of some of the latest, greatest technology.
Now on ATETV. From across the country to your own backyard, ATETV shows you the many advanced technological education opportunities available at your local community college. Do you see the glasses half empty or half full? If it's a glass of clean drinking water, you might just see it as your next career. Let's take a look at the world of water treatment technology.
Water is depleting all over the world, and I mean, we just have more and more need for fresh drinking water.
Everyone needs water, and we have limited supplies of water. Obviously, if you have the ability to take salt water, which we have much more of, and convert it into drinking water, then there's a resource there that has plenty of water in it. Desalination has been around for a long time, but this is a new facility, and basically we take in brackish water, salty water, water with high conductivity in it. Water goes through a treatment process to remove any bacteria, and then high conductivity water goes through a reverse osmosis system, which removes the dissolved salts. Then from there, we disinfect the water for drinking water purposes. To be an operator, I like to have people that have a basic fundamental understanding of water treatment. And you have to be analytical, and you have to be detail-oriented with certain parameters that you have to make your water within.
There's a lot of data collection, you know. You have to take a lot of samples, you have to record flows, you know, how much water is coming into your plant, how much water is going out of your plant, how much is being filtered, how much is filtrate is being taken out of the system. I mean, you do some maintenance, you know, you have to work on pumps, you have to learn different types of valves, you know, and you need to have some computer skills. State-of-the-art plant, it's, you know, top of the line, it's $80 million worth of equipment. Because I had the education I had from the school, they were very comfortable with, you know, taking me on.
It is an interesting field. I think it's a field that's growing, and I think that there's a lot of opportunity for people that are interested in this type of work.
The world will always need safe, clean drinking water. That means the engineers who are trained to help produce that water will always be in high demand. If you're interested in the environment and helping people, be sure to visit your local community college for more on the water treatment technology programs they offer. It seems that every day we hear about another company or business who's had their computer system compromised by hackers. As more and more cybersecurity threats pop up, the demand for qualified IT security technicians will continue to rise. Let's meet Sean Coughlin, who's studying to begin a career keeping data safe.
Here's your router. It'll go to the firewall.
Yeah, but I don't know where these came from here. So.
My name is Sean Coughlin. I go to Springfield Technical Community College, and I'm in the Information Security degree program.
Configure an enable.
Just do the network.
The port on the firewall that the router is connected to.
The Information Degree Security Program is designed to teach students like me to go into various businesses to help them secure their networks against different types of attacks. Your information is stored on a computer system somewhere. Most people think, oh, I don't use online banking, I don't put my credit card into websites, that it doesn't affect them. But that's not true, because the businesses that take the information from them do use computer systems and do use the internet. So the need for security professionals is increasing.
And then you're going to start setting up firewall rules on your router and firewall rules on your ICE.
I've been interested in computers for a very long time. I mean, I started with a Commodore VIC-20 when I was a kid. It was always just a hobby.
See, protection updates.
I was a commercial flooring contractor for 18 years. I stayed in floor covering for as long as I did because the money was there. I was self-employed. There was a lot of freedom. But my desire to work with computers finally took over, and I made the change, and that's how I got into this field.
Oh, it's because I can't.
No, it's right.
I'm not connected
it's right
to the internet, yeah. And I can't update.
You have to take networking classes. That's bare bones. You've got to have that. They give you some of the more liberal arts as part of the program, as you would expect.
Connecting a LAN to the internet.
And now, as this course is related, this is specific to security.
So in the Juniper program, you're going to have to put in the route, a static route. Are you in Juniper?
Working on actual Juniper routers. This is really hands-on. We're in here dealing with the physical equipment, the cables, everything.
You're going to have a crossover cable. What you do is you put this in the middle.
6890.
Oh, it's working. It's working.
What else is plugged into the
every box? Single job you look at, they don't want to see just school. They want to see experience. And to be able to say, I've actually worked on the device, and I've configured it, I've taken it out of the box brand new, I put it together, and I got it working, that's a solid foundation that employers want to see.
Companies in all areas of business need to keep their computer networks safe, and they require skilled IT security technicians to do it. If you're interested in a career in information technology security, be sure to visit your local community college. Looking for a career in a cutting-edge field? Want to have the work you do be part of the renewable energy movement? Then studying fuel cell technology could be for you. Have a look at this fuel cell program happening at Stark State College.
Fuel cells are the future.
The industry is so young. Careers offer great potential.
A student that studies fuel cells is going to have a wide range of opportunities available when they graduate. Technicians that are needed within the lab itself to be helping to build the technology, to scientists that are figuring out how to solve the challenges within the fuel cell industry, to the managers that are then running the companies.
Where are we going to get this water that we need for it?
From building the fuel cells to understanding the properties of fuel cells and creating new materials to increase the performance of the fuel cells. Graduates have to have a desire to learn a new technology that's not in the industry today.
Did you blow that out before you put that in there?
We look for problem solvers, especially with a small company like ours where we have a lot of technical challenges. We're really looking for someone to take on a problem and to attack it.
Now your motor's up now. So,
well, now your motor is higher.
Since a kid, since I was 5 years old, I always tore stuff apart and tried to fix things.
They're able to come in, get into an activity that has meaning. They can put their teeth into it. And I think if I were a young person, that's the kind of thing that I would be shooting for.
My interest in it is mainly because I want to be in on the ground floor of some of the latest, greatest technology.
There's going to be expansions that are happening, whether it's in sales, marketing, engineering, technicians. It's starting up a whole new infrastructure, basically.
This loop here with that valve.
They're decent, high-paying jobs with a lot of responsibility and a lot of accountability.
It gives students an opportunity to work on a type of technology and in an industry that has not already been predefined. So they get to work on new challenges and they get to develop things that no one else has developed before.
It's not like you're walking into something that's done and dusted. You know, you're actually walking into something that has a lot of opportunity in front of it.
Fuel cell programs like that one not only respond to industry needs, they are often ahead of them. That means those students will be on the ground floor for exciting, innovative fields and high-paying career paths. For more information on anything you've seen today, explore our website at atetv.org. Thanks for watching.